Welcome back to New Rockstars. I'm Erik Voss, and Morbius stars Jared Leto as Spider-Man villain Morbius the Living Vampire in Sony's ever-confusing side universe to the MCU that Michael Keaton tends to wander in and out of like a sneaky nursing home resident that the orderlies call a runner. But now we got a trailer that I'm sure will get us all pumped and clearly answer all of our questions about Sony's live-action Spider-Verse plan. So I'm gonna watch this trailer, react to it, and give my initial thoughts and explanations. And then tomorrow, in a separate video, I am going to break down this trailer frame by frame for all the visual details and Easter eggs that you might have missed. But on to the reaction. Here we go. Oh, Sony's got to do their trailer to the trailer, so you know what's coming in the trailer.
You need a doctor?
I am a doctor.
I am a doctor.
I should have died years ago.
This music.
People all over the world have my disease.
I'm here
to find a cure. We have to push the boundaries. Take the risk.
Ugh. Do they have to do it with the rustiest machete? Bat! Oh, cool. Jim Morrison's, The Doors. People are strange. Very moody music, but there's some deeper themes that connect with this.
What did you do to yourself, Doctor?
I wish I knew.
What'd you do to yourself? Oh, Horizon. Okay, that's interesting. Peter Parker works there.
It worked.
Not exactly. I have increased strength and speed. Some form of bat radar.
What else can I do?
Whoa. Whoa. Oh, Oscorp. Oh, interesting.
There's something inside of me.
Wants to hunt
and consume blood.
Michael.
And you control it.
Whoa! I saw Black Cat on there.
We haven't had anything this good since that thing in San Francisco.
Oh, that again? That what?
You and I should stay in touch.
I'd do anything to save a life. But I don't know what I'm capable of.
You save lives, you don't take them. Are you here to heal the world? Or to destroy it?
Oh, I like how the blood's draining out of the title. That's kind of cool. What? Okay, sure, but why would you say... got it. Okay, a quick reminder here. Dr. Michael Morbius is a medical genius with a rare blood disorder that you can see here hampers his movement, but in the comics, that also caused poor Michael to look naturally just a bit beastly. But here, he just looks like a honka-honka Jared Leto. So Dr. Michael Morbius experiments with vampire bat blood serum and electrotherapy to become Morbius the Living Vampire. He has various sexy vampiric powers, but he is not technically dead because his powers did not come from any supernatural source, but rather from science. Also, fun fact, Morbius ties in with Blade in the comics. When he bites Blade, he actually allows Blade to then live on with the powers of a vampire, but none of the weaknesses, which is pretty useful. Thanks, Doc. Now, going bald is stressful for the guys I know going through it. Sure, it's not the end of the world, but much like a bag of Halloween candy or a Christmas stocking, you would probably rather have that sucker be full full than empty. Two out of three guys will experience some form of male pattern baldness by the time they're 35, but with Keeps, it's easier and more affordable to get treatment for your hair loss and help you keep the hair that you have. Keeps offers generic versions of the only two FDA-approved hair loss products out there, but at half the cost of your local pharmacy. Though you never have to go to a doctor's office, with Keeps, you get 24/7 access to a doctor who designs the best plan for you. They offer other helpful tools and services, including a tracking tool so that you can monitor your progress. Find out why Keeps has more 5-star reviews than any of its competitors, and nearly 100,000 men trust Keeps for their hair loss prevention medication. So if you're ready to take action, prevent hair loss, go to keeps.com/newrockstars or click the link in the description to receive 50% off your first order. That's KEEPS.com/newrockstars. Now, since the first trailer for Morbius came out in January 2020, you remember, 20 years ago, that showed Spider-Man graffiti and a cameo by Michael Keaton as Adrian Toomes Vulture from Spider-Man Homecoming in the MCU, and he also shows up in this trailer. It's just kind of hard to tell what universe exactly this is all supposed to be set in, but this trailer ends with Morbius transforming his face briefly into a monstrous snarl, and then he claims to be Venom, which would mean that this is the universe that Venom and Venom Let There Be Carnage with Tom Hardy, Eddie Brock are all set in, at least before the Let There Be Carnage post-credits scene teleports Venom to the MCU. Who knows what happens to that world afterward. Another bit of evidence here is there's a shot of a Daily Bugle newspaper, and it's got the same masthead design from the Sam Raimi Spider-Man movies, which is also the case in Venom Let There Be Carnage, but there is some weird stuff going on with this newspaper, it looks like. It reads, Dr. Michael Morbius apprehended for, quote, vampire murder, end quote. And I gotta say this, maybe this is just my journalism degree talking here. This is a horribly written headline. Like, did Morbius murder a vampire? Or was it a vampire-style slaying? I don't care if it was a quote, it's still unclear. Also, full name and title in the headline? On the front page? Full spread across all six columns? Whoever this editor was, fire him, even if he has a heart condition. And yeah, there's some Easter eggs here. I'll definitely get more into this in the breakdown, but you can see Rhino on the loose, Zoo Hoax fools us all, and Black Cat, friend or foe, referring, of course, to the Spider-Man adjacent villains, Rhino and Black Cat, also apparently in this universe. And then on the far left, Finding the Truth Within, told in his own words, another horribly written headline, like, who are we talking about there? I don't know, maybe it's a nod to Peter Parker finding his truth within. I don't know, whatever. I'm gonna go more into this in the breakdown. But the trailer also opens with the Oscorp building in the skyline and another tower in construction beside it. Now, Oscorp Tower, the headquarters of Oscorp, of Norman Osborn, the Green Goblin. This was last seen in 2014's The Amazing Spider-Man 2, but it was a different building, suggesting that this is definitely a different universe than the Mark Webb films. We have been waiting to see Oscorp Tower show up in the MCU. Some are believing it's what Avengers Tower is being constructed into. I personally think it's gonna be the Fantastic Four's Baxter building, just because I don't know how long Marvel thinks they're gonna be able to get Sony properties in their universe. But I am more interested in the second building that's under construction next to it. Like, is it suggesting that Oscorp is expanding? That could be the reason why there's a Rhino in this universe. Maybe how they're gonna justify how we have Black Cat and Kraven the Hunter and all these other spider villains in a universe with some kind of corporate backing. But also earlier in the trailer, we see another building with Horizon on it. That's gotta be a reference to Horizon Labs. That's a place where Peter Parker builds his spider armor in the comics, eventually leading to the tech of the Alchemex Corporation, which is how we get Spider-Man 2099. It just seems like in general, in this movie, as compared to Venom or Venom Let There Be Carnage, Sony is really reaching a lot of different directions with various intentional Easter eggs to try to imply an expanding Spider-Verse. Does that mean Morbius is gonna show up in Spider-Man No Way Home? I highly doubt it, but I think this trailer is a way of saying, look folks, after you see Spider-Man No Way Home, don't worry, we got some plans for how we're gonna expand our spumsy. And everyone's like, what's a spumsy? And they're like, we'll work on the name, but we got plans. But we gotta talk about the music here. This is The Doors' People Are Strange, a song conceived by The Doors' frontman Jim Morrison and Bobby Krieger. This was supposedly after Jim Morrison would go walking alone through Laurel Canyon in Los Angeles back in 1967. I can see Laurel Canyon right outside my window. It's just on the other side of the forest fire smoke and the smog. But I mean, I love The Doors. Morrison's haunting voice, it is a pretty natural fit for this movie's gothic aesthetic. Reflects the isolation Morbius feels from the rest of society. But I like any song that forces you to think more than a second about it, because the line, Faces look ugly when you're alone. That was Morrison's way of saying when you're alone and you don't actually see any faces around you keeping you company, that idea of other people can just seem really ugly to you. But of course, the irony of the song is that the people aren't strange, you are. And that's something Jim Morrison was totally aware of when he wrote this music. I don't know, he's probably on LSD when he wrote it. But that's when it opens your mind to really speak the truth. A truth that he was like melodically basing on the old school 30s cabaret style music.
Life is a cabaret, old chum.
This song repeats the word strange. When you're strange, when you're strange. I mean, we gotta talk about this, folks, because is it not for the actions of strange that all these worlds are colliding and everything is so confusing? In fact, another eccentric New York medical doctor. Of course, Michael Keaton as Adrian Toomes returns in this film, and here he tells Morbius,
"You and I should stay in touch."
And in this moment, it looks like they're like passing each other as both are in police custody. I mean, I don't know, folks. To me, this suggests that whatever multiverse collision from Spider-Man No Way Home has already happened at this point of the story, and that Morbius could be taking place on the other side of that, like after the universes have merged. But then again, Morbius was originally scheduled to come out in August of 2020 before Spider-Man No Way Home, which originally had the release date of July 2021. So maybe they were gonna like tease that by having an unexplained cameo of Michael Keaton, a character from the MCU? I mean, ultimately, to be honest, I don't expect Morbius to have much of a good explanation for how they're in the same universe. They will probably just hope we don't think too hard about it and hope that we just see all of this as, oh, all these Marvel characters are in one universe. It's not really clearly defined. They just happen to have not crossed paths yet. And some of them have no idea what the blip was somehow, because I think that was the implication of the Spider-Man graffiti shot that's once again in this trailer. And this particular graffiti of Spider-Man is the Sam Raimi era design that was on the loading screen of the PS4 game. I mean, I don't know, maybe this Morbius universe is taking place in the future of the Tobey Maguire universe, and that future just happens to have a criminal that looks like a popular MCU villain. It is also conceivable, folks, that Morbius could just exist in a universe that has a Venom, and that has a Spider-Man, and the Daily Bugle, and a Rhino, and a Black Cat, and a Michael Keaton Vulture, and is still its own universe, just separate from all the other ones that we've seen. That has some of those details, like the coincidental convenient overlap that is in the shape of Michael Keaton. Now, in another video that Sony released yesterday, Jared Leto used the term web of possibility, which when you look at him saying that, it just seems too on the nose. It's almost like a Sony producer was coaching him to say that in that promo, just to get fans like us excited to see this movie for the chance that Spider-Man might pop up in photos and newsreel footage like he did in Venom Let There Be Carnage. It's just so transparent. I mean, hey, maybe there's an audience out there who doesn't need connections to Spider-Man to enjoy this vampire movie. Because yeah, we are getting some cool looking supernatural vampire action, creepy demonic face, smoky Death Eater teleportation that sometimes goes in slow motion, all these swarms of bats. But in this case, the struggle I'm having is that, you know, at least with Venom, the VFX and character design was pretty cool to watch, but I'm not really sold yet on Jared Leto as this buff vampire. And that's coming from someone who loves vampire mythology. It's like we're throwing that all out the window and just making science the source of the vampiric elements. It's like taking all the things I like about science and all the things I love about vampire supernatural mythology and merging them while leaving the cool parts of both those things out of the picture. At the end of the day, I think we can all agree. Is anyone interested in anything else about this film other than the insights it's gonna give us into Sony's general mindset for what they're doing with their other movies? I don't know, am I being too hard on this? Let me know what you think about this trailer in the comments below. I'm hoping I am proven wrong. You can support New Rockstars by checking out our merch options at newrockstarsmerch.com. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at EAVoss, follow New Rockstars, and subscribe for breakdowns of everything you love. Thanks for watching, bye.